When Europe was in the Dark Ages, the Middle East was thriving, believe it or not. All right, so I'm honored to have here in the studio, Alp Ottoman. How are you doing today?
I'm doing fine.
Did I get that right?
You did perfect.
All right, to the viewers out there, say your name again.
Alp Ottoman. Like, Middle Age was very eco-friendly. Is this eco-friendly new thing? No.
No.
Middle Age
was always been there.
Well, by nature, it was eco-friendly. Because there was no big glasses.
Right.
They were producing small glasses. That, if they had the big glass factory in 12th century,
they would have used it.
Check it out, the whole cathedrals. Between piers, all glass, actually. The first structural skeleton system in 1200, 1300. You know those windows?
Oh, yes.
Unbelievable.
The stained glass was like remarkable.
In between, yes. There are, you know, metals, leads, which hold those little glasses. But what a ingenuity. What a creative right. effort. And how, I don't have a big glass to do that, how I can do that? Then I can put the small glasses. You know, in Palladio, architect Palladio, at his time, the marbles during the construction were broken. And instead of throwing those non-shaped marbles, yes. they put them and filled in between concrete and the gypsum, and then polished them, it became a Palladian floor.
A creation from...
So in other words, they were using...
Recycling.
So is recycling a new item?
No.
Here we go. I took you to 1500.
And we fast forward and then we come back to 1500.
That's right. If there was no, for example, wood, probably we would not have industrial revolution. The first gears, first
okay.
everything, wheels, first axes, first carts, everything was from wood. Mills.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, 1900. On Rhines, there was wooden mills, and they turn into factories because they used the river. Before, they were using the river to turn the mill.
Yes.
Now they use the river to bring coal to the factories. Yes. And the whole Rhine industry developed out of that. And now, watch. What we do, nuclear reactors, no?
Oh, yeah.
Power plants.
But it's like
nuclear energy, great. We are advanced. Yeah. What do you do with the nuclear energy? You boil water to get steam.
Back to the steam.
And put the piston back and forth.
So no? We're constantly reinventing something that was already
technology
inventing.
Is changing, but this, the main subject is there.
All right, Alp, let me go back talking about public space. We brought up the Tiananmen Square. We brought up several other ones, the Basilica, not square around there. What about public space in America? I think you made the statement, New York Times Square.
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe you ought to define public space.
That's
maybe
right.
Historically, public space has been for military parades and strength and define public space.
Well, the latest what you said is the for the military parade and for extravagant power shows. I think that is a politically prepared big, huge areas. I will not call it public space, although it has been used by the public. But public space means you want to go there and enjoy there something.
Maybe a private moment.
Yes, absolutely.
Maybe a get away from it all.
Yes, absolutely.
In this age of technology with iPhones and that, maybe you just want to sit there.
Absolutely.
Maybe play a game of chess.
Yes. Yes, all Italian town squares, you see somebody, you know, on the side, they play chess. Mm-hmm. A car pass doesn't bother. A horse pass doesn't bother. Two kids play, it doesn't bother. First of all, it is the most important institution of the public space of human being created throughout the ages. It is a marketplace. It began as a marketplace. Market is the most important public area.
And you get all the social interaction.
Everything.
You meet people. You engage in conversation.
Yes.
Agora.
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 Shops, stores around. There is a temple. And then people do come there for daily necessity functions.
So like in the city of Monrovia, it's almost like the Friday night festival.
Absolutely.
The streets blocked off.
Okay, let's say for Monrovia,
mm-hmm.
I will go back to history.
Yes.
But in Monrovia, that
street, Myrtle, downtown Myrtle.
Myrtle Street is a perfect public place.
Okay.
I will use the word place rather than square. When I say square, it's understood that it's a official square.
Set off to the side
yes,
or something.
And nothing else but that. No. Public space every time, everywhere can be handled. An arcade is a wonderful public space. Rue de Rivoli in Paris, in front of the Louvre Museum. It goes almost 2 kilometer length of arcade. Unbelievable public space. Bologna. 16th century Bologna, all arcades.
Mm. Well, why haven't arcades been?
It's a protection. It allows additional space for pedestrians to use shops, etc., etc.
And it probably is very therapeutic. Your mind is taken away.
Yes.
From the 8-hour grind.
Yes. And coming from the old, probably monastic periods, that chiostro means the courtyard surrounded by the arcades. In Italian, it's called cortile, which is a meditation walk. And they used to do it as long as they can, that they can have a long meditation around the courtyard. So
that's funny you say that, because you have people that go to the mall to do that same thing.
Absolutely.
They call them the mall walkers.
Absolutely. But and also separate the hierarchies of main pedestrian roads,
yes,
shouldn't be cut off, and then additional separate shopping or sitting or dining or whatever arcade, and then building.
All right, now.
So it's a wonderful human enterprise.
So a viewer that may be listening may say, what about the Grove? How would you define that architecturally?
I think Grove is a wonderful public space, despite the buildings are not good.
More commercial oriented.
Yes, kitschy, I would say, but.
Kitschy, define that. A different word
is,
for me.
Kitschy is trying to imitate the childhood of the proper imitation.
Okay. Kitchen. Not really a good replica.
Yeah. A kitsch may be the childhood sickness of a creation. We may call it.
But the Grove is good.
But the system is middle-aged system.
Okay. Back to that again.
Yes. Street and shops at the side of the street. What is lacking in Grove is the arcade.
What was the bird nest? That was in...
That's a wonderful... can you imagine? you are at the center of that area, what you will feel. The only thing is, it is for the spectacle.
Yes.
It is an arena, Colosseum.
Yes.
So.
Back to the days of the Roman Colosseum.
Yes, but it is a public utility, but not a public space.
Not a public space.
But a public building. Public spaces, in front of that, is a public space.
Which would make it more friendly,
a beautiful square, and you're approaching to a bird nest structure. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And you want to go there with your friend to have a coffee and chat, not to look at them.
That's secondary.
To put your back to the wall and to look the rest of the space. It looks like looking to the cathedral or sitting in front of the cathedral and putting your back to the cathedral wall, that you are in a safe world and you look at the space.
Because so, it's the space that we want so much.
Yeah, we need that every day.
Because why? Does it serve as a stimulant to our mental capacity?
Of course. You are individual and also you are part of the society. You live both of them, both privileges. Nobody bothers you. There is a common denominator. It is a political choice. It is not a God, I shouldn't have that.
Yes, yes.
And everybody has a participation there, and there is a mutual agreement there. Nobody is complaining, my place is longer than your place. That's what the public space is. So all of a sudden you perceive, you love, you smile.
Right, right.
That's what the public space is. It can be road. It can be agora, marketplace. Mm-hmm. It can be forum, imperial place. It can be town hall square. It can be guild building square in front of it. Mm-hmm. It can be arcaded, labyrinthine roads, streets. It can be a beautiful area covered with, at the periphery, with the trees.
Right.
You tell. Mm. Everything may have a public domain in itself.
Should have.
Should have.
Because
that is what the architecture is. Otherwise, everybody knows how to live within four walls.
Yeah. the four walls that everybody wants to get away from.
Yes, and nobody sees the other one's four walls unless they go to that house. What they see is the street facades, everything, public buildings.
So that's as much as we want to get away, we want to still have that freedom to gaze and to look out and to watch.
Absolutely. And if we spend 10% of energy that we spend for luxury, we can solve this problem.
So that's
politicians.
That's why it's so vital for people to be involved in the Planning Commission.
Well, I will not go into that much bureaucratic way, but the Planning Commission at least should be aware of this. They should offer rather than now.
But sometimes their vision is skewed. They see the structure.
Then people should ask them, because otherwise it will be a fight. I don't want the people fight with the commissions. I want to ask to the commissions, why don't you think like that? Let the commission change themselves. We put them there not to tell us what to do, but
to listen
serve
to
us and listen us.
Provided that it's practical.
That's what I pay tax. That's why I have the right to ask from them, please do help me, but in a proper way. What is proper? Let's have a look to the history. What was proper? Look at that. Oh, it's beautiful. Then why don't you think that?
Mm-hmm. Then what was here before that worked so well?
Yes.
Because there's always something that was
there. I'm talking porch. Do you see any porch now?
Now, porch is sort of like outdated.
Why?
Probably cost effective. Don't need a porch.
That's right.
Well, the need is there.
That's right, because it is a square foot or square meter.
Yeah. The economics.
When you cover it, your building will be more expensive. But, you know, you sell your human part for a couple of square meters. Is it a prideful something? So, again, we are going back to watch the stacks of cotton, stacks of ships, stacks of containers, whatever gave you prosperity, happiness, and make the life easier for you, and feasible and rational. That's going to be the future city, and also we have to limit the size of the city, because that's very important. We are not as advanced as technology. I'm using the word in terms of nature. And we are trying to follow it, and we are getting tired. We are not supposed to get tired. So we have to manage the size in such a way that, as Leon Krier says, every city should be within a walking distance. 10 minutes walking, you must pass from one end to the other end. That's what the city is. And then another city with a beautiful bridge you can connect, again, 10 minutes walk. Decentralized cities. Cities within a cities, world within a world. It doesn't matter which material you use. Whether glass, stone, iron, everything comes from the earth. So, we're not going to use the carbon, you know, mixtures of metals, because we're not controlled by the radar. We don't need stealth house. That is what I'm trying to do, is to say that modern architecture is going to be a stealth architecture. No, that's the war weapon. That's another thing. Architecture is a public element. That's all I will say.
On that note, yeah, it's time to wrap it up. I got to bring you back in the studio to talk about more of architecture and how it advances forward, but at the same time, we explore history. I want to thank you so much for being here today.
My pleasure. Also, I would like to say that architecture is not separate neither from history nor from daily life. We are not private people. We are not special people. We are just like everyone else. We are just supposed to help and to serve for the public domain.
All right. Thank you so much. I'm glad that you're here.
Thank you very much. It was wonderful.
Good. What a ride. What a journey.
Yeah. We touched so many, you know, peers.
Only to find out that we didn't talk about anything new. I mean, in a sense.
That's right.
We went back.
Yes.
To the wheel.
Yes.
And fast forward.
Yes.
From nuclear energy.
Yes.
That boils water.
Yes. To turn the wheel.
To turn the wheel.
Well, we are the part of the universe. We are not designing. It has been designed. Uh-huh. I don't mean only God.
Right.
I mean, it is there.
Well, we're instruments of.
Of course. Constraints. The power of constraint. That is the name of my second book. If there is no constraint, there will be no design, no thought, no industry, no life.
Scary.
Check it out. If you say that the constraint is a wonderful challenge for me, then it is a wonderful life waiting for you.